On a summer Saturday, these ghosts are suiting up, disappearing in the corn, only to emerge as ball players reliving their glory days.
We're pretty old. We still get to put a uniform on.
34 years after filming Field of Dreams, thousands still come to this little slice of baseball heaven in an Iowa cornfield. Even on a hot day, it still has the power to give kids and full-grown adults chills. People come all the way from Japan.
I'm going to give it to the lady from Japan.
God, Japan's pretty good.
Just to see this field and ghosts come alive to play the game they love.
Whoa!
34 years ago, these guys were actually in the movie, cast as the ghost players. But they had no idea they would be part of a timeless classic.
And so I nearly turned them down. In fact, I did turn them down. And then my mom bailed me out and said, I'll watch the kids. Go do what you're going
to
do.
100 players from the Dubuque area tried out to be in the movie. About 20 made the cut. These three, all from different teams, were cast. The now friends, sharing bush lights and cracking jokes, were heated rivals back in 1988.
And we knew of each other, but we didn't really know each other.
You can say it, Obe. We didn't like each other.
Three strikes, you're out at the old ball game. Hey!
They admit they thought they were hot shots, starring in a baseball movie. Trying to impress the cameras on day one, a deep fly ball toward the corn was heading straight for Frank.
So I'm out there on day one, and a ball comes out there, and like, here's my shot. And I'm going back, I'm giving everything I can to get to this ball, and I don't think I ever touched it. But I fell off that ledge that I didn't know about and knocked down like five rows of corn. And everybody on this lot is screaming. And I jump up and say, I'm all right, I'm not hurt. Yeah, and they came out there running past me and said, look what you did to the corn.
After realizing they weren't the stars, they asked for a copy of the screenplay. Their first reaction?
It was kind of disappointment because this isn't a baseball movie.
And as far as the iconic line, is this heaven? No, it's Iowa.
I personally thought that was a little quirky at the time, but it turned out pretty good.
In April of 1989, Field of Dreams hit the box office. After a slow start, it took off and became the timeless classic we know today. Because of that, their lives changed forever.
We've gotten to live our baseball dreams for the last 34 years. Yep. Met every Hall of Famer we ever grew up admiring. Done events all over the world. Get treated like heroes. And yeah, it's all because of being extras in a movie in 1988.
Well, the Ghost Players have sealed their spot in baseball history on this now iconic field. But the prospect of Major League Baseball coming to Dyersville still seemed like a dream.
It had to be 6 or 7 years ago, and we're sitting under the trees just like we are now, having a cold one and telling stories about the day, and there's a survey crew working out in the middle of the field. And we asked Keith, you know, what's going on? And he says, well, don't you guys tell anybody, but Major League Baseball is thinking about putting up a stadium out there. And we had a good laugh, and we're like, yeah, we're going to tell anybody that story, Keith.
You know, you can
visit us when they lock us up.
But Major League Baseball did come to Dyersville, and the first major league game in Iowa had a movie-like ending on a perfect field.
We've been on diamonds all over the world, and that's the prettiest surface I've ever seen. It's just gorgeous.
34 years have passed since they filmed a little movie in Iowa, and now this field means something to everybody who visits it. On any given day, you'll find a father and son playing catch, with dad trying to hold back tears, a grandpa from the other side of the country in amazement. Kids not knowing they're making memories they'll chat about decades later. For these ghosts of the past, this field means everything.
We're going to try to give back to that little field the rest of our lives, and we're never going to get close to repaying what it's done for us.
In Dyersville, Scott Carpenter, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's News Leader.